Can.
The new NBA reversible jersey, the attitude of a champion, available at Foot Locker.
The following is an exclusive presentation of Turner Sports.
The true legends of rock and roll have inspired a legacy that has endured the ages. For 50 years, the NBA has created its own legacy, showcasing the classics, breakout sensations, and performing artists with identities all their own. Yeah! Live from Cleveland, NBA All-Star Saturday and Rock and Roll take center stage on TNT.
USA 50 years ago, the NBA's golden anniversary celebration continues in Cleveland, Ohio, where the greats of the music world are enshrined, and the NBA's elite have gathered for All-Star Weekend. They are legendary figures in a half century of memorable moments, and today we were treated to a photo op for the ages. Tonight they're making tracks for Gund Arena, packed for an evening filled with one-of-a-kind skills exhibited by players who are here by invitation only. TNT presents All-Star Saturday live from Cleveland's Gund Arena. And good evening, everybody. I'm Ernie Johnson. The next few hours are dedicated to rookies with the energy of Little Richard, shooters whose jumpers float through the air like Sam Cooke's vocals, and skywalkers who can rock a house like Jagger and the Stones. And joining me, a Motown coaching legend. Chuck Daly is here. And Chuck, whether you're coaching in this weekend as you have before or whether you're just here watching, it is so special.
Well, I think this is more special than usual because of the people who are here, the legendary players, and the fact that they're all getting each other's autographs, something they really like to do themselves.
And the photo opportunity this afternoon, just something to behold. Behind me right now, the rookies are warming up for the first event of the night, the Schick Rookie Game, and we have a couple of grizzled veterans who are going to call it for us in just a moment. What are we going to see? Kobe Bryant, the likes of Kobe and the other rooks. After that, one man, one shot at $1 million, Chuck. His name is Jim Valenti. Later on, as the night goes on, it'll be the AT&T shootout. There's Glenn Rice, one of those gunning for fame tonight in the Nestle Crunch slam dunk. Ray Allen is a rook. He's in there. Bob Sura, the hometown favorite, could be heard from also. Behind me, of course, they're warming up for the Schick Rookie Game, and a couple of wily veterans going to call this thing for us. Dick Stockton and Hubie Brown, let's go courtside, guys.
All right, Ernie, we may be wily, and we may be grizzled veterans, but we do not play for the Grizzlies, although they have two rookies in the game today, Hubie. And if you want to look at a crystal ball to see what the NBA is going to like with some of the stars down the line, you're going to see it in this game because you're going to see some of the top prospects playing today. And I think that, Hubie, this is only the fourth year of this game. It is picking up incredible momentum, and we're getting close games and exciting games, and is really taking on a great identity.
Well, the fans love the game. It's great exposure for the 16 players that are chosen. And then as you look at the past, we've had very competitive games. They've been decided by 2, 4, and 6 points, one of the games in overtime. The three MVPs, Penny Hardaway, Damon Stoudemire, and Eddie Jones, have all stepped up to the next level and have made a major dent beyond their first year.
And, of course, a lot of the number one draft picks are not playing in this game, which says something about the people who are playing in this game. So What about the fact that these guys want to accomplish something? If you're a rookie out here, what do you want to accomplish in this particular game?
Well, Dick, what you're looking for as a player, you've only been together one practice session for an hour's time. So you're looking that the coaches will give you at least 15 to 20 minutes. You want the shot attempts. You would like everyone to be unselfish. But all-star games are always dominated by guards. They have the basketball. The inside people are at their mercy. So let's hope we see good team play and not too many turnovers.
Speaking of turnovers, we hope to see a shot that people are going to be anticipating, and that is the American Express million-dollar shot that comes up right after this game. For more, let's go to Craig Sager.
Well, Dick, after spending a considerable amount of time with Jim Valenti this week, both at his home in Florida and also at All-Star Weekend in Cleveland, I'm beginning to like his chances to make this million-dollar shot for three reasons. Number one, he owns his own resort and doesn't need the money. Number two, he does his own TV commercials and doesn't freeze in front of the camera. And number three, he and his coach Oscar Robertson have tried throughout the practice sessions to closely maybe simulate the pressure of the moment. They went to a sold-out arena in Orlando between the first and second quarters last week for that game between Orlando and Houston. He made one out of four. And at the All-Star Jam session, they gave him the exposure of thousands of cameras and media. He took his shot, banked it off the backboard, and it went in. So I think his chances to make this mill, I make him even money. Ernie?
All right, thank you, Segs. And add to the equation the fact that his wife, Kathy, is celebrating a birthday tonight. How about $1 million for a birthday present? But only Chuck Daly was able to pull that thing off. First order of business tonight, the new kids on the block. First-year stars in the NBA showcase, the Schick rookie game. Vitaly Potapenko, he's a hometown favorite. And here are others you'll see. It's All-Star Saturday on TNT. Thanks for being here, folks. Settle in.
NBA All-Star Saturday Night on TNT is brought to you by the Schick Tracer FX, designed for sensitive skin. By Castrol Sensec, the synthetic motor oil that protects in ways other oils can't. By Genuine Chevrolet, the cars found in more driveways across America, the cars more Americans trust. By the Fannie Mae Foundation, showing America a new way home. And by Foot Locker, where it all begins.
Don't expect too much from yourself, Michael.
Start on varsity.
You can't play at the level of North Carolina. Be realistic.
Forget the team. Think of yourself. Why go back to basketball? You'll embarrass yourself.
Had enough?
Just getting started.
Another torture test. We drained the oil from this car and added just this much Castrol Syntec. We then ran it over 100 miles per hour and waited and waited and waited. You see, Syntec has a unique molecular structure that bonds to engine parts, protecting them under the most torturous conditions. And if a little Syntec protects this well, imagine what a full oil change can do. Castrol Syntec Full Synthetic protects in ways other oils can't.
I'm sure by now you've heard about our new TR3000 window. Beautiful, durable, energy efficient, a breeze to clean. But we haven't talked much about money, and maybe we should. Maybe you're concerned about the investment in replacing all the windows in your home. So here's an idea. Replace just one. Call us at 1-800-527-9800, and we'll send you our one window program. Think you can't afford quality replacement windows? Think about what you'll save. How can you afford not to?
The Simpsons are expecting, so they came to Cable Dahmer Chevrolet Geo looking to trade up for a new Chevrolet with a little more room, but they still wanted something sporty. With Cable Dahmer's 8.5 acres of cars, trucks, and vans, plus special good neighbor financing, they had no problem finding all the space they need. Come see us at Cable Dahmer Chevrolet Geo Mazda on the Miracle Mile Nolan Road, Independence.
Welcome back to Cleveland and All-Star Weekend. And in just a moment, we're going to take you back inside Gund Arena. But first, let's spend a moment or two in the Turner Arena. Regular
viewers of Inside the NBA on Tuesday night know that this is our virtual reality venue, which this week features the TNT Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. Let me give you the nickel tour through the Walk of Fame. This wing dedicated to breakout sensations like former NBA Rookies of the Year Wes Unseld, Jerry Lucas, and others who have taken the fast track to greatness or the stairway to heaven. You know, even legendary acts were rookies once upon a time. Remember the first time that you heard the Beatles harmonies? Oh, we had all those 45s. Used to sing them in the house all the time. And they still sound great. Same story with James Brown, the godfather of soul. Still popular. Worked the Super Bowl. And so it is with breakout sensations in the NBA. Remember the rookie year of the artist formerly known as Lew Alcindor? Kareem Abdul-Jabbar, the NBA's all-time leading scorer. Or the first-year emergence of lifelong New York Knick, Patrick Ewing. Or how about the first time you witnessed the all-around brilliance that is Grant Hill's game? Tonight, some NBA rookies with designs on greatness are ready to rock Gund Arena. It's the Schick Rookie Game.
All right, and we're getting ready for the introductions of the rookies competing. And for that, let's go to the Cleveland Cavaliers public address announcer, Jeff Shreve.
And now the participants in the 1997 Schick Rookie Game. First, the West team. He started playing in the NBA in 1948 and coached until 1982. The coach with the most wins in New York Knicks history and coaching the West team, Red Holzman. Assistant coach for the West in his fifth year on the Los Angeles Lakers bench, Larry Drew. The trainer for the West is Ted Arzonico from the New Jersey Nets. Injured and unable to be here from the Minnesota Timberwolves, Stephon Marbury. Also injured and unable to participate from the Dallas Mavericks, Samaki Walker. This big man has added inside power since moving into his team's starting lineup. From the Los Angeles Clippers, please welcome Lorenzen Wright.
Go, go, go!
This player is battling for the rookie lead in blocked shots and field goal percentage. From the Vancouver Grizzlies, Roy Rogers.
Go! Go!
This Canadian point guard has a natural grasp for running an offense. From the Phoenix Suns, Steve Nash. A rookie point guard who found himself in the starting lineup. From the Houston Rockets, Matt Maloney. This 7-foot center was an academic All-American in his last year at UConn. From the Los Angeles Lakers, Travis Knight. This high-flying guard dunks and can score from outside or in traffic. From the Los Angeles Lakers, Kobe Bryant. This speedy point guard has provided his team with valuable contributions at the point guard spot off the bench. From the Los Angeles Lakers, Derek Fisher. Forward and the co-rookie of the month for December from the Vancouver Grizzlies, Sharif Abdur-Rahim. Now the East team. He's been involved with the NBA since 1946 and his name has become synonymous with the Celtics. The head coach of the East team, Red Auerbach. Assistant coach for the East in his first year as an assistant in Atlanta, Bill Henslick. The trainer is Gary Briggs from your Cleveland Cavaliers. This inside four scored 23 points in only his second pro game. From the Boston Celtics, Antoine Walker. This big man has provided his team with stability in the post and a shot-blocking presence. From the Indiana Pacers, Eric Dampier. He shared December's Rookie of the Month award. From the New Jersey Nets, Terry Kittle. The 1996 NCAA Player of the Year and number two pick in the 1996 draft. From the Toronto Raptors, Marcus Camby. Sharpshooter ranks atop all rookies in three-point shooting. From the Milwaukee Bucks, Ray Allen. A point guard leading all rookies in scoring. The 1996 number one draft pick and November's Rookie of the Month from the Philadelphia 76ers, Allen Iverson. With a quick move to the basket, he's an offensive force on a powerful front line. From the New York Knicks, John Wallace. A big man who leads all rookies from the free throw line. He earned the nickname Ukraine Train while at Wright State. From your Cleveland Cavaliers, Vitaly Popenko. Ladies and gentlemen, the players in the 1997 Schick Rookie Game.
And there they are, many of the top draft picks and one free agent who came from the CBA. Matt Maloney, who's in the starting lineup for the West that boasts three members of the Lakers. Sharif Abdul-Rahim of Vancouver. And then we have Kobe Bryant, Travis Knight, and Derek Fisher, all from the Lakers, and Matt Maloney from Houston. For the Eastern team, it'll be Antoine Walker and Marcus Camby up front, Eric Dampier from Indiana, the center, Kerry Kittles, and Allen Iverson in the backcourt. Now, here are the rules for this Schick Rookie Game. There are two 15-minute halves. Personal fouls are counted, but no player can foul out. There are only eight men on the squad, so they get a chance to show what they can do. And if there is a tie at the end of the game, the first team to 3 points wins the game. And as Hubie mentioned, we have had close games throughout this rookie contest. Last year, Rasheed Wallace hit a jumper, and then Joe Smith missed a three-pointer as time ran out. And the East won, Hubie, 94-92 in a thriller.
They've been very good. Majority of the time, we get unselfish play. The thing that you're looking for here from a coaching standpoint is you just want the guys to play hard, give the ball up when a guy has an open shot.
The officials working this rookie game, Nolan Fine, Bill Spooner, and Michael Smith, as we take a look at 79-year-old Red Auerbach, who led the Celtics to 9 NBA championships, 8 in a row. And Red Holtzman, who led the Knicks to 2 memorable titles in the 70s and played on an NBA championship team with the Rochester Royals way back in 1951.
When I was in college at Niagara, the following fall, we played 5 exhibition games against the Rochester Royals.
That must have been a thrill.
Oh, come on. It's Bobby Davies and Red Holtzman.
Bobby Wanzer
and Arnie Risen, who was here last night. It was just a thrill. You're absolutely right.
Allen Iverson trying to save it to Kerry Kittles. Teams are wearing their own uniforms. The East in the home white. We're playing in Cleveland, and the West in the darker uniforms.
Iverson has 23 points a game. He's had 7 assists, but he's right at the top of the league in turnovers. And you can see right there, that pass, he tried to thread a needle, and the inside guy never got a chance to see it.
Here's Kobe Bryant, who about a week ago became the youngest player ever to start an NBA game. 18 years and 5 months against Dallas, and he is a wonder. Kobe Bryant playing under the pressure of playing with a contender.
Well, you know, when they gave him a starting chance, he averaged 15 points. So, you know, he was doing a bang-up job. He's a three-point guy, and they also love to post him up.
Kobe Bryant, of course, his dad, Jelly Bean Bryant, played in the NBA. 13th pick from Charlotte, traded to the Lakers. His rights were for Vlade Divac. So on the turnover, it'll be the West ball, coached by Red Holtzman. And here is Derek Fisher, who was the backup point guard before Kobe Bryant actually took over that job for the Lakers. And Bryant went up, had it stripped away, out of bounds. Last touch by the West. Kobe Bryant, who was 21 points twice. Those are season's high thus far. Antoine Walker tries to get it into Camby, who converts.
Well, Camby's had a difficult time in the first half of the year with numerous injuries, but anytime that he has the minutes, he gets it done.
Travis Knight is fouled going in. Interesting story with Travis Knight, who was the 29th pick in the draft by the Chicago Bulls, who renounced his rights. And the Lakers picked him up, and he has played more and more, nearly 15 minutes thus far.
Now, you like his effort. He's an excellent offensive board man. He's a good defender. You know, his last 2 years, he averaged 9 rebounds a game at the University of Connecticut. And he has been a pleasant surprise for the Lakers. You love his attitude, Dick.
Eric Dampier committing the foul, and Travis Knight, who has not been a good free throw shooter, hits them both. He has been 54% from the line.
Well, are you his shooting coach? Because I know you had that last one just for, you know, the excitement, right?
Well, I need about Don Nelson's winning basket.
Yeah, that's right. Very good.
Against the Lakers,
that's
huh?
That's right.
You think to win the championship.
You don't think we don't look at that film a few times? Here is Camby on a pick and roll to Dampier, loses the ball to Kobe Bryant. And Harris's pass to Matt Maloney, and Maloney threw it right in the hands of Antoine Walker. Players who are playing for teams that are not winning get the most playing time, and this is back down the other way. Series of turnovers, and Derek Fisher, the rookie from Arkansas Little Rock, who was the 24th pick, gets the layup to make it 6-2 in favor of the West.
Remember, we told you they just met yesterday. They worked out for less than an hour, and as you can see, we said let's not have any turnovers. We only had about 13 so far.
They're giving hard fouls, UB, in this rookie game as Gary Kittles has hit going in. So we've already had 7 turnovers in the game, and Kittles will shoot 2.
Now you're going to see Matt Maloney just dish off here to Derek Fisher. Derek Fisher has really made an excellent contribution in the backup point guard role behind Nick Van Exel with the Lakers. He's participated in 44 of the 46 games.
3 rookies on a contending team. Right now, the Lakers, the number one record in the Western Conference, so that says a lot for their maturity.
Well, you know, the Lakers really like Fisher. He was the Sun Belt Conference Player of the Year, and he played at Arkansas Little Rock.
Kobe Bryant from downtown. Kobe Bryant hits a 3, so Bryant now has 5 points of the 9 for the West, who moved out to a 7-point lead. Kittles missed both free throws at the other end. Here's Allen Iverson feeding Camby, and Camby scores. The top 2 draft picks last year, Iverson number 1, and Camby, the College Player of the Year, right behind.
I like what I saw right there. Iverson came off, took it right into the lane. He could have forced the shot. Instead, dropped it off.
Here is Raheem, has it stripped away by Allen Iverson. He may be feisty and may be outspoken, but he's spectacular. And he's one to watch. Pass inside to Dampier, who slams it through. Eric Dampier, and I'll tell you, one guy's got to admire that is Wilt. Maloney goes in, has it deflected out of bounds by Kittles. It is still West ball.
Well, Eric Dampier was the 10th pick in the draft by the Indiana Pacers out of Mississippi State. And he stepped in for Rick Smits, who missed quite a few games in the early part of the season. Dampier, they love his talent. Size, long arms, good rebounder, shot blocker.
Here's Maloney firing a 3 and missing. Dampier battling Knight for the loose ball, and it's kept in bounds. Abdul Rahim misses from long range. But you're right about Dampier, who started 21 games, and of course getting to the Final Four last year with Mississippi State didn't hurt either. And a whistle and a foul as Iverson was fouled trying to beat Derek Fisher off the dribble, and Fisher picking up his first.
When you look at Allen Iverson, you realize that there is no one player who's going to stop him defensively. He is so clever with the basketball. His first step is an explosive step, so he can get a shot anytime that he really wants. He can force up a shot.
that says a lot. And, you know, he's not a bad playmaker either. Knight, with a great feed from Maloney, could not finish the job, but he's fouled. And Travis Knight will go to the line. Talk about Houston Rockets waiting to get back. There was Clyde Drexler.
Now, right out of the CBA, Matt Maloney. This is a nice feed off. What I like about Maloney's doing tonight, he's distributing the basketball. And then once again, we tell you, another factor with Travis Knight, he's 7 foot, but he runs the lanes, Dick.
And there are two members of the University of Connecticut Huskies. Ray Allen and Travis Knight in this game, and over the top.
You're right, he came out of the mezzanine.
Yeah.
Over the top.
Literally over the top.
That's right.
That's basket interference.
Keep an eye to your left. There's Kobe coming. Now, naturally, it's basketball interference because he held on to the rim with that left hand.
So Vitali Potapko comes into the game, the favorite of the Cleveland fans. Potapko from Wright State, and the jumper. And it doesn't take long for him to get the cheers of his hometown.
Well, I tell you, Dick, he has great hands. He's excellent face in the basket, and he has a low post game with his back to the basket.
Maloney over to Abdur-Rahim. Look at Kobe Bryant coming out of nowhere and nearly tap one in. Here's Iverson, 2-on-1 with Kerry Kittles. A couple of former Big East players couldn't convert, and Maloney has Fisher and Bryant with a reverse jam. Kobe Bryant now with 7 points in the game. And the score is 12-8 in favor of the West with 10:33 remaining in the first half. 15-minute halves. Iverson beats his man off the dribble, and he made it look easy.
You're absolutely right. I mean, he just blew by, Fisher. Okay.
And the leading scorer on his team, you know, he doesn't just shoot, although he'll take the shots, averaging 7 assists as well. Kittles on a nice steal, gets the ball back. And Potapko can't convert out of bounds. And now we're going to go to the bench.
Well, anytime that you watch All-Star games, you know the game is played in peaks and valleys. Plus, there are an awful lot of turnovers. Players like to open up, try to do fancy things. This is an unselfish play. Now here comes Bryant with a reverse.
7 points for Kobe Bryant. Ray Allen of the Milwaukee Bucks has come in the game along with John Wallace, who plays with the New York Knicks. And Wallace will...
Campy will inbound the ball.
And into the game now, Lorenzen Wright, who replaced Samaki Walker of the Dallas Mavericks. Wright, who is the 7th pick in the draft from the LA Clippers, will be coming in, and a timeout has been called. Each team can call one timeout in the first half. Well, time to bring you up to date on what we have coming up on the NBA on Turner next week. Tuesday on TNT at 8 o'clock, the Detroit Pistons red hot with the sensational Grant Hill against Miami. That'll be a great matchup. Wednesday on TBS at 8 o'clock, the Orlando Magic, who have come back strong after a slump earlier in the year against the Detroit Pistons. And Friday night, Hubie will be at Atlanta on TNT at 8 o'clock when the Chicago Bulls go against the Atlanta Hawks. The Hawks beat the Bulls earlier this year at the Omni. And tomorrow, of course, on NBC, the NBA All-Star Game beginning at 6 o'clock Eastern.
It's been a great experience, Dick, being in a hotel where the top 50 players, you know, over the period of time of the NBA are staying. And it's really nice. You see Moses Malone here, and Lenny Wilkins was in the previous picture. And Dr. J, you can see the faces here. And then we have Clyde Drexler in your screen. And we know that Clyde had to step out because of a hamstring injury. There's Kevin McHale doing a great job as the general manager. And who's that guy with that green jacket?
Right in the middle. Look at Magic, Jordan, and Bird, all right in the middle. And you know what was even amazing? They have this 50th anniversary book with the color photos of all the players, every one of these players getting autographs of the other 50 members, like a 6-year-old kid would.
Well, yeah, it's a great time to step back, reflect on the history of the league, because they're the ones that have put the game into the status that it is today. And there's a young fellow right there with a few rings in his in his drawer, John Havlicek.
They're all here, and they're all going to witness this NBA Saturday night. Marcus Camby with a high arcing jump shot, and Lorenzen Wright in the game taps it over to Bryant. 2-point lead for the West with under 10 minutes to go. Kobe Bryant with a reverse layup. Looks like he wants to try to nail down the MVP award in this first half.
Well, there's no doubt about it, Dick, that every time he gets the ball, he's looking at the rim.
Allen Iverson controlling the ball, working against Fisher. He's beaten him off the dribble several times already. Trying to do it again, but this time Roy Rogers in the game takes it out of his hands. And the feed to Bryant a little behind him. As Hubie mentioned, these guys just got to know each other. But talk about a guy who can pass behind his back as well as anyone he did today, the Coos.
Well, I liked when the TNT and the NBA did the film for 2 hours for television. Bob Cousy saying, you know, back in the old days, I was going behind my back and through my legs, and today every kid in the 12 years of age is doing it in the local playground.
But he was the first. Give credit.
That's right.
Steve Nash is coming to the game, the rookie from the Phoenix Suns. And Otapenko committing the foul, and Maloney will inbound. So Roy Rogers, Lorenzen Wright, Nash, Maloney, and Iverson very nearly with the steal. And missing outside is Bryant.
Wow. Tough floor.
Lorenzen Wright has his shot blocked away by Campy, and it is still West ball.
Now you got to see on this loose ball, I was just watching right in the middle of your picture, off the hip. Now that's Nash out of Santa Clara, who's playing with Phoenix.
Iverson all over Maloney, and here is Lorenzen Wright. And good defense that time by Potapenko, and loose ball. Here is Bryant, and fouled by Camby underneath. He wasn't going to let Kobe get the easy layup there.
Now, Kobe Bryant is showing us an awful lot of energy, but I also think that he should, you know, try to play with the other four guys that are on the floor right now, okay? You know, the game will come to you when you play these kind of games also.
He's already taken six shots. A little under 9 minutes, so another turnover. And Camby's going to go out, and Antoine Walker comes back in, who played with the national champion Kentucky Wildcats. And Walker playing 32 minutes, as you might expect, starting 31 games for a team that's really having its problems, the Boston Celtics. Ray Allen with a fall away, banks it in against two defenders.
Ray's having an outstanding year for a rookie playing the two-guard position for the Milwaukee Bucks in that starting lineup.
Tied at 12, nearly 8.5 minutes remaining.
Matt Maloney
hits the jump shot. There's an Iverson fan. Too early to get the autograph, sweetie. Wait till the end of the game. Iverson controlling now, guarded by Nash. Wallace working against Kobe Bryant. And Iverson crashing the boards, and Antoine Walker on the follow tips it in.
Antoine Walker is looking at this game as a night off. You know, this is like playing in the park. Because when you have to line up night in and night out as the starting center for the Boston Celtics, give away inches and maybe 50 pounds and get pounded physically.
And leading the team in rebounds at 6'9". Last guy to do that was Dave Cowens, the redhead. Potapenko with the basket, his second of the game. Everyone on the East has scored except for Kittles and Wallace now. And Lorenzen White at the other end with an acrobatic shot. The score now is 16 all with 7:45 and running remaining in the first half. Rogers guarding Walker. Walker in the lane. That was reminiscent of Magic's shot ever against the Celtics, as Bill Russell, another former member of the Green. Nash misses a three, and here comes Iverson. Finding Walker. Well done by Iverson, and Walker filling the lane. 4-point East lead. Now Bryant setting it up. He's guarded by Antoine Walker. Matt Maloney's played the entire game thus far for the West. And Bryant takes yet another shot and hits it. A 3-point basket, his second of the game. And Kobe Bryant now with 10.
Well, Jerry was in love with his talent. You can see already he's a definite 3-point player. He's excellent off the dribble. He can post up with his back to the basket, and he can fly in the open floor.
And better than Jerry said he expected.
Well, you know, 6 foot six, Dick, he's got the total package.
Long rebound on Walker's miss. Mr. Nash to Maloney. And it looked like he might have been fouled, but timeout will be called. It'll be East ball. 1-point lead for the East rookies in the Schick rookie game. 6:35 remaining in the first half.
is a guy thing, right?
Schick brings you the shaving system for sensitive skin.
Is this a sensitive part?
Designed to give a smooth shave with less irritation. Schick. Tracer FX.
See the sensitive type? I like that.
Designed for the man with sensitive skin. Schick Tracer FX.
Someday, my office will have a window. Someday, my boss will be me. Someday, I will meet the man of my dreams. Guess not today.
The Chevy Camaro's 200 horsepower, 3800 V6. Therapeutic, isn't it?
Good morning.
Good morning.
What can I do for you?
Two copies, please.
Yesterday, Evelyn Hartwell fulfilled a dream. A dream big enough to change her life, small enough to hold in her hand. She got the keys to her first home.
Thank you.
By the way, congratulations.
For a free guide that can help you get a home of your own, call the Fannie Mae Foundation. We're showing America a new way home.
Couple of guys named Red coaching this game. Red Holtzman, 14 years the Knick head coach, and of course the legendary Arnold Red Auerbach, 16 years. He is the one link throughout the Celtics lore, currently president of the team. And right now let's go to one of the former MVPs of this rookie game with Penny Hardaway, is Cheryl Miller.
Thanks a lot, Dick. Obviously, Penny, you have a lot of fond memories, 94 MVP. What were some of your memories like?
Well, I think the biggest thing I remember is Doug Collins triple-teaming me. That's probably the biggest thing I remember about the rookie game. I was yelling at him, saying, hey, this is a rookie game, all-star game, man. Let me play.
Let me tell you, who's really standing out in your mind in this game so far?
Well, I think Antoine Walker. I have to give props to my man Lorenzen Wright. Ray Allen. I think those guys are really standing out right now.
All right, thanks a lot, Pick. Let's go back to you, Doug.
You're not surprised about Doug Collins' eager style in this game, are you? The All-Star game?
No, and you know what it was? The guys at that time, that year, were very competitive from the coaching standpoint. They really went after their guys and forced them to play hard. And they at least had at least three or four set plays that they all went in the day before.
Lorenzen Wright committing the foul, and John Wallace missed the free throw, and Antoine Walker. Well, Penny Hardaway knows wherever he speaks. Antoine Walker, he sees playing well and converts there.
Well, you know, Walker is so talented, Dick. The guy can play almost any position. The Celtics, during the course of the year, have played him at the point, two, three, four, and now five.
Sharif Abdul-Rahim coming back. And Popepko with the shot. He has 6 points. So Walker, Potapenko now the leading scorers for the East. Sharif Abdul-Rahim, Antoine Walker playing serious defense out there. Here's Nash going down low, and they're going to call Ray Allen with the hold as Travis Knight and Allen Iverson comes back in.
He's fouling with 34, Ray Allen.
Right now you're going to see Potapenko put this one away. And what I like about him, Dick, he went into the Chicago camp last year. There were 65 players, and he was definitely heads and shoulders over the other 64.
Nash misses a three, so Potapenko, who hails from the Ukraine, goes out of the game. Dampier replaces him, and Kerry Kittles misses the mark. Iverson all over the court, trying to get every rebound and every steal. Oh, yes. And there is Sharif Abdul-Rahim, who is the leading scorer on the Grizzlies at 17 a game and their second leading rebounder. And he's playing nearly 34 minutes of action. Allen missed from outside, gets the pass back from Kerry Kittles, and a blind reverse layup misses. Rogers with the rebound. 26-23, the East leading with 4:50 to go, and they claim that Kittles had stepped out of bounds, so it'll be West ball.
Now on this finish, you're going to see to the right of your screen, Abdul-Rahim. Now this young guy is the total package. When you realize that he would only be a sophomore in college this year at the University of California, he has it all. He can run, dunk is there, good with the basketball, off the dribble. good post-up player. He doesn't have a lot of weight as of yet, but in the next couple of years, you're going to hear big things about him.
Travis Knight hits wide open from the corner. Abdur Rahim out of the University of California ranks among the top five in about five or six categories amongst these rookies. Kobe Bryant back in there for the West. Dampier overnight. Knight doing a solid job. Got a piece of that one.
He sure did.
And here is Bryant, and Iverson knocked it away from behind. And a three-on-one break, and Marcus Camby, he ought to be in the slam dunk contest with that move.
That was pretty.
Camby with six. And it's 28-25, the East leading with 4:12 to go. Roy Rogers missed. Inside, no foul. Camby with an alley-oop. Oh, Perry Kittles, and was that a beauty? Remember, these guys haven't worked together.
Perry Kittles has done a fantastic job, Dick, with the New Jersey Nets. We're talking about a guy who's, you know, up over that 25 mark a number of nights. Everybody is kind of surprised with the numbers that he's putting up there. He's doing a good job shooting-wise and the minutes.
And Larry Brown said Perry Kittles is the best rookie I've seen in the NBA this year.
That's quite a tribute.
Iverson, no look to Camby, and the East putting on a show now, leading 32-25.
Yeah, you're sitting out there and you're saying, well, why are some of these guys averaging so many points with teams? The other guys are not, and they're in this game. Everything is minutes. Right. You got to have your minutes and you got to have shot attempts. If you're drafted by a good playoff team, you're not going to get the minutes that some of these other guys are playing on bad teams.
Allen Iverson now with five assists in the game as he feeds Camby, who has eight or ten. So Camby with ten, and it's 35-24, an 11-point lead for the East. And Allen Iverson is a show, isn't he?
Look, he has had over 35 in games. Now, when he cuts down on his foul, his turnovers, and he starts shooting a higher percentage by getting into like 46 to 48 percent, then his scoring, who's going to stop? This is just a great drop-off pass in the camp because he just can fly by anyone. Cut back the turnovers, shoot a higher percentage, don't make the game difficult. And when he gets this all together, watch out, because he's the type of player that can get you 50 in a game.
Every member of the East squad of eight has scored in this game, and now Derek Fisher is on the free throw line. He was fouled by Marcus Camby. Fisher replacing Stephon Marbury of Minnesota, and while he's here and not playing, Marbury is a great story. Coming out of Georgia Tech and really doing the job. You mentioned the great job that Kevin McHale has done with two great jobs, Kevin Garnett and Marbury, two fine young players.
Well, you say Gugliotta, Garnett as your cornerstones, and in Marbury in the backcourt, you have three of the great young talents that we have in the league. Plus, they are playing to their potential. It's a big start having potential, not getting it done. These three guys are doing it.
That was Dampier on the slam, Kobe Bryant, who does not have many assists as Allen Iverson has taken a shot. There is Joe Bryant. Maybe that's a strategy. Look, no, you're 18, who knows?
Jelly Bean was in the league for a number of years and then ended up his career over in Europe. Kobe, naturally the family traveled with Jelly Bean, and what happened when they were over there is that Kobe had his education, speaks fluent Italian. It was a great experience for their family.
And that was against the Dallas Mavericks, youngest player ever to start an NBA game. Matt Maloney will replace Derek Fisher in the lineup for the West. Maloney, 25 years old, is the oldest of the players in this Schick rookie game. Bryant with the free throws makes one. He has 11 points. 8-point lead for the East, 36-28 with 2:40 now remaining in the first half. Kerry Kittles for three, he's got it. Kittles coming in as the third leading scorer on his team, the Nets.
Well, he can make the threes, Dick. And also, if you fall asleep, be very quick to the basket on the dribble.
Knight bounces it into Roy Rogers. Just off the front rim, and Marcus Camby into the hands of Antoine Walker. Here's Walker with a move, and Dampier follows up. And as Hubie mentioned, when you get a chance to play, and Dampier got a chance because of the Rick Smith's injury, and he made the most of it. missing for three, Kobe Bryant, and there's Travis Knight against Wallace converting.
The advantage of having a baby hook shot. That was a nice move by Travis.
Camby at the other end comes back. And with under 2 minutes to go, it's 43-30. Rick Barry looking on, and you've got to be amazed at what these rookies, the talent that they have now. Here's Kobe Bryant, picked up the loose ball on the bounce pass. Bryant now with 13 points. He is the game high scorer. Marcus Camby leads the East with 12. Here's John Wallace firing a three. Wallace this year has only tried three from downtown and hit one, so that's not been his shot. Not so for Maloney. Misses as well from three-point range. And a no-look pass goes nowhere for Antoine Walker. Bill Murray in the crowd. And watching this great weekend here in Cleveland's Gund Arena.
This is just a nice pass right down in. Nice pickup by Kobe Bryant. You know, during the summer, Dick, Kobe Bryant, for the L.A. Summer League team, he averaged 25 points a game. And that opened the eyes of all of the free agent players, CBA guys, players who were drafted by the teams who participate in the L.A. Summer League. So not only did he have the talent, he was drafted. The trade was made. Vlade Divac from L.A. to Charlotte, Kobe Bryant to the L.A. Lakers. They put him in the Summer League. He delivers. He shows you that he can score. Now, we know that there's the Summer League, then the exhibition, then the regular season, and the playoff. So there are really four seasons of intensity, meaning the defense and then how you have to stay within the offensive philosophies.
Kobe Bryant, of course, is going to be a busy guy tonight. On this All-Star Saturday night, he's one of six contestants in the slam dunk contest. Ray Allen as well. Bob Sura, who played in the rookie game last year representing the Cavaliers.
That is just a nice... Now, that was a loose ball, and it just carried right on through to Bryant. But like I said, that was a nice pickup.
Bryant has 13 points and 6 rebounds. Knight is second with 7 points. Camby with 12 points, and Walker with 8 lead the East. As we wind down to a minute remaining in this first half, Maloney has it deflected by Iverson. Gets the ball back and has it rejected by Dampier out of bounds. So a tip ball by Iverson and a sheer rejection.
We had a double block. Iverson, you see it right here. And then as the ball hits and goes, Maloney makes a nice move. He thinks he has it. Dampier just sends it out of here.
And Maloney goes in again. Well, he's getting a lot of resistance, trying to get off an outside shot or a layup. And Kittles from Iverson. So Kerry Kittles, and he's waiting to get back and help the Houston Rockets.
Well, that guy in the picture has done many of those dunks, you know, in the air. The acrobatic shot and catch.
He's one of the 5 slam-a-jammers at the University of Houston. Dampier with a good outlet to Iverson. This time he'll take it himself. He had Camby there, but Allen Iverson with the basket is second, but he's been active. And a 15-point lead for the East rookies. 24 seconds to go. Iverson has Camby. This time he goes to the big guy. And it's now 49-32, a 17-point lead for the East. Maloney goes through a crowd. Great no-look pass to Abdur-Rahim. That was a great pass by Maloney. He's giving the Rockets what they need in that department. Kittles from Iverson, and the East is beating the West down court. Iverson has 8 assists here in the half.
Well, you know, during the regular season, when guards drive and get inside the lane, because of team defensive velocities, people automatically rotate back. In All-Star games, you don't have that. All the players play under different defensive rules. So, you know, you see a lot of sloppy play. You see a lot of fast-break basketball.
And you see a lot of spectacular play. A lot of that from Allen Iverson. Travis Knight got that last basket. And at the half, here at the Schick Rookie Game, the East leading the West by a score of 51-36.
Always and forever. With you is just like a dream to me that somehow forever.
What are you doing to the boards?
Throw elbow.
Guy's on a fast break.
Trip him.
The guy looks at you.
Refer to his mother.
What's this? He's got it. No more Mr. Nice Guy.
No more. No more.
Wait. This isn't me. I gotta play with decency. Honesty. I gotta play clean. Nice shot.
Ain't nothing out this late but the devil.
Let's get ready to rumble.
Okay.
Well, that furry temptress seems like she's calling your name.
Yeah, give it to me.
She said, come on, Rashawn. She said, I swear that I would never.
Say, Judge, we're gonna do this or what?
Booty call. Tell your mother I say hello here.
Rated R. Opens everywhere February 26th.
A father and his son square off in a head-to-head half-court battle. Father, a former NFL star, can't stop his son.
Hill gets the basket. What a terrific play by Grant Hill.
Playing his dad made Grant Hill feel like he could do anything. Now, on court in the NBA, he can.
Thanks, Dad.
See the NBA's best every Tuesday, Wednesday, and Friday night on TNT and TBS. Don't miss a game.
Saturday in the park in the summertime means a trip to the Jake. All-Star Weekend in Cleveland. Well, it has to include a visit to the Flats for a little nightlife. At least that's what Chuck Daly tells me. And a trip to Gund Arena for All-Star Saturday. And you're looking at the blimp shot from the Goodyear blimp, the 72nd consecutive year that a Goodyear blimp has covered the nation's top sporting events. You know, they play 15-minute halves in the Schick rookie game. They've scored 87 points in the first half. You don't usually see that in 15 minutes of play at the home of the Cleveland Cavaliers, but that's the story here as the East enjoying a healthy lead over the West. Marcus Camby has 14 points. Kobe Bryant has 13. Ernie Johnson and Chuck Daly here. And if you like your stuff up and down here, Chuck, we got it.
Well, we've got 17 turnovers, but I'll tell you, a lot of the league officials would love to see the game played this way, up and down. We played a slow game in Seattle the other night, had 20 turnovers in the half, but Allen Iverson's been the story.
He certainly has. He's not the leading scorer by any means, but he has been dishing, and Marcus Camby can thank Allen Iverson for a lot of his 14 points. Now, still to come tonight, folks, we've got the American Express million-dollar shot. It's going to be taken by 49-year-old Jim Valenti. You see him there. His name was drawn at random after a 13-month nationwide contest was held at Champs Sporting Goods. He's getting ready for his moment, and we turn it over to Craig Sager. Thanks.
Well, Ernie, since Jim Valenti's name was drawn on January 23rd, he's been practicing the same shot from the same position for virtually 2 hours a day. Now, the two-hand set shot may be a thing of the past, but I actually think it's to his advantage. Despite small hands, he can now get a firm grip on the ball that is steady but gentle. And also, the stance allows him to get more legs and body into the shot, making it easier for the ball to get to the basket and with more control. The last-minute advice from Oscar Robertson was, it's not a tough shot. It's all in the knees, all in the legs. Don't force it. And that's advice from the Big O, who has won virtually every award in the history of the NBA, including Rookie of the Year in 1961 when he averaged over 30 points a game and 10 rebounds. So the Big O giving advice to Jim Valenti. And when we come back, we'll have more rookie memories as we continue our All-Star coverage on TNT.
NBA All-Stars Saturday night on TNT is brought to you by Jeep, makers of the Jeep Grand Cherokee, and Wrangler, and by Champion.
Yeah, I'm a football guy, but I like the other contact sports too. Yes, nothing like the sound of a good hit. Now that's how the game was meant to be played. Only Pro Player has reversible home and away jackets, sweatshirts, and hats for pro teams and college. That guy should have been a linebacker. I've won 2 Super Bowls. I know a winner when I see one. Pro Player reversible jackets. Reverse it.
Hooray!
Big event.
Pulling. Starting. Motor.
Boat.
Motorboat.
Hitching.
A towing.
Pulling a boat.
Trailer. Tow vehicles.
RV.
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah. Broadcasting. Bait casting.
Fishing.
Gotta be kidding.
It's fishing.
What?
Fishing tackle.
Backpack.
Swimming.
Biking. Canoeing.
Driving.
Traveling. Vacation.
Okay, boats, RVs, fishing tackle, hunting and fishing vacations.
The sport show.
We like it.
The sport show.
And we're going right now.
Everything you need for the great outdoors is indoors at the sport show. February 11th through the 16th at Bartle Hall.
Behind every great woman, there's a story to be told.
I have no regrets, Sarah. I regret the things I didn't do.
Their defining moments. What they achieved. Who they loved. Why they struggled. How they survived.
And say simply, with hope, good morning.
Women who have changed the world. Stories that will change your life. Intimate Portrait.
In Cleveland, Kobe Bryant has 13 points and 6 rebounds. But everybody from the East has scored, and they have a 15-point lead at halftime of the rookie game. Oscar Robertson is probably the only player who gave a clinic every time he stepped on the court. And right now he's giving his last-minute advice to Jim Valente, who after the rookie game will have one shot for $1 million. You know, changing times and evolving dynamics make it difficult to compare players of different eras. But I think it's safe to say that the rookies of today do not have the same rookie orientation.
Those were the days, my friend.
I didn't go for all that rookie orientation stuff, you know. I said, if you want me to get rebounds for you, leave me alone.
We thought they'd never end.
My teammates had a funny sense of humor. Should have been sitting them left when I should have been sitting them right. So I got dunked on a lot.
Singing times forever and a day.
I had to carry bags and stuff like that. And of course, I was the dumb rookie, and I made all kind of rookie mistakes, and they had so many laughs.
Live the life we choose, we'd fight and never lose.
Oh, you were tired all the time, not from playing, from carrying guys' bags. You know, I had to carry Doc's and Moses, Maurice Chief, Andy Tony bags. We had to take Andrew Tony warm milk every night. We had to take Doc a paper every morning.
Those were the days, oh yes, those were the days.
I think now, you know, you tell a rookie to do that, and they're not going for it. And no one is really pressuring them to do it now. I think when we came in, it was just a ritual, and we felt that we had to do it.
I think the number one thing, I always had a love for the game of basketball. And I was reading an article today in the USA Today, and I guess Jordan and Barkley and all those players talked about playing for the love of the game. I think when I first came in, I wanted to develop my game first, and then hopefully get paid. But I think nowadays, sometimes some of the younger players, not all of them, sort of reverse that mentality.
The rookies come in and they're making a lot of money and they're expecting and they get seen so much on TV and stuff, all the stuff that happened now, making the rookies not as humble as I think they should be.
Coming up, my friends and I always talked about, man, one day you're gonna have your own shoes.
I never got my own shoe or had Charles Barkley jerseys in stores. You know, that stuff that happened to at least you made the All-Star team 5 or 6 times. Now if you come into the league, they got your jerseys, you got a commercial, you got your own shoe.
When I came in the league, I had so much respect for Truck. I mean, I looked up to him. I'm not sure guys coming in the league looking up to Karl Malone like they should and Michael and Charles Barkley. Akeem like they should, you know, because those are great players, and you need to look up to them and actually learn from them.
I don't think any of them really know about the history of the game. This whole thing with the NBA at 50 is probably an enlightening experience for them, so that they understand that there were basketball players prior to Larry Bird and Magic Johnson.
Not as humble as they should be, lacking in respect, no sense of NBA history. Let's get a rookie's view. Kobe Bryant watched that piece and then spoke with Cheryl Miller.
You have to look at it from both perspectives. You know, I can understand where the older players are coming from. At the same time, the younger players coming into the league, I don't know if it's a sign of disrespect, but all the younger players want, speaking as myself as well, we want what they have. You know, we want to achieve what they've able to achieve and able to accomplish. So I don't think in younger players' minds we're really disrespecting the other players, but I think in their mind, from their own experience, we are.
And you can get in trouble, I think, Chuck, when you make blanket statements like, these kids don't do this, these kids don't do that. What's your take on this relationship at this point?
You know, I agree with you, Ernie. I think the fact it's kind of a false sense of not security, but they, I think down deep, they respect these people. And I think the game, as the years go by, teaches humility. When you don't make all-star teams, when you lose big series, it has a way of kind of leveling the field.
The NBA's rookies have the all-star spotlight on All-Star Saturday here on TNT. It's 51-36, the East with the lead. Nobody's ever scored 100 in this game. Could happen tonight. Second half coming up.
Monday on CNN's Burden of Proof, the jury in the Simpson civil trial calculates how much he'll pay in punitive damages.
Could he lose his Rockingham mansion? Monday, 12:30 Eastern on CNN.
This Sunday on National Geographic Explorer, the popular sport of sumo has taken Japan by storm. Sumo, Dance of the Gargantuans, National Geographic Explorer. Sunday, 7 Eastern, only on TBS Destination Sunday.
Attitude of a champion. Available at Champ Sports.
When did you stop loving me? How have I been a memory? Darling, did you stop loving me?
Celebrating the NBA at 50, Nestle brings you One-on-One, a matchup of NBA stars, past and present. Dave Bing is considered the Detroit Pistons' first true superstar. He was a fierce competitor and a smooth offensive player who led the league in scoring in 1967. Today, Joe Dumars might be considered Detroit's unsung superstar. This five-time All-Star has been an important cog in the Pistons' engine with his offensive spark, defensive tenacity, and quiet leadership.
Well, there's the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame here in Cleveland, and the East has been rocking and rolling. And while Hubie, most of this year has been superb defensive play that has kept the scores down, and there is Elvis, who did not get in today to see the Saturday, but he is on display, and what a great display it is over at the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. But the fact is, we're seeing a change of pace in this rookie game than what we see in the regular season, 51-36, and it's up and down, and I think that's what the fans like to see.
Yeah, well, you know, the Western team is struggling, only shooting 37%, they're 2-for-10 in threes, and just can't get it going, and their guards are getting caught, and then Iverson is just breaking the defenses down, just blown by people, so it's a layup drill and a dunking drill. So it's kind of nice if you're cheering for the East, and if you're a Western fan right now, you're not too happy.
Still 15 minutes to go in the second half, and we have had a lot of spectacular play and a lot of great dunks.
Yeah, you can see right there that this, everyone is getting their chance. Closest thing to defense is the wind that is being on as people are flying through and attacking the rim. A couple of nice lob. Kittles has had a couple in also, can't be finishing. Kobe Bryant, you know, leading the scoring here for the West with 13 points. And then Camby doing a great job, 14 points for the Eastern team on 7 of 9 shooting.
And you mentioned Allen Iverson, who's taken only 2 shots from the field. He has made both of them, but has 8 assists in the game. So we're underway here in the second half. Sharif Abdul-Rahim of the Vancouver Grizzlies, formerly of the University of California, with a great pass tonight. That was a underhanded pass tonight, who could not convert. So now Iverson with Camby, Kittles, Antoine Walker, and Eric Dampier. Knocked away, but controlled by Dampier. And the Indiana Pacer out of Mississippi State hits the jumper. He has 8.
In the 3 previous games, Dick, we've definitely had much better defense. The players went after one another a little bit tougher than what we're seeing in this year.
Every year is different, and traveling is called. So Dampier travels, and the West will take over. Again, want to remind you, we got 3 big games coming up next week. TNT on Tuesday, Detroit at Miami on Wednesday on TBS, Orlando at Detroit, and Friday on TNT, the Chicago Bulls against the Atlanta Hawks in Atlanta, all games starting at 8 o'clock. That was Matt Maloney hitting from downtown. That's the 3rd 3-point basket for the West. Camby misses the layup, and here's Kobe Bryant, but the East getting back on defense.
Well, the West, they just opened up here now. Play a little defense, knock in a couple of threes, take it to the basket, get some easy layups.
And Camby might have knocked that ball away as Walker and Camby double-team Bryant, and it is a turnover, and it'll be East ball.
Outside of being ice cold, you said the West only shot 37%. They complicated it with 9 turnovers, Dick. When you're playing a 15-minute half, that's a ton.
Antoine Walker with a stop and go draws the foul. Abdur-Rahim with the foul, and so Antoine Walker going to the line. He is the Celtics' highest pick in the last 10 years, and he has done a terrific job, as we said, off the boards. And, of course, plays for the team that once led by that man, Larry Bird. But hard times in Boston these days, UB.
Yeah, it's very difficult. It's hard to play in the league without a center, and they have 3 guys on the injured list who play that position. The team is trying to play with 5, you know, 6'6 to 6'6'8 players. Antoine Walker doing a terrific job for them. And we know that his true position is probably the small forward. So you have a lot of guys playing out of position there, but they're hustling, they're scrapping, they're trying to do the best they can.
Abdur-Rahim double team, forces it up, and here's Camby. A 4-on-1 right now for the East Stars, and Iverson.
There you go.
There's a switch and rolls. Camby going to Iverson. Those two have worked it mighty large in the first half, 56-39, and 2 minutes gone by here in the second half.
This is what Kobe Bryant loves to do, and that is post up, throw to fade. Iverson doubled down. Beautiful shot block.
That's the second time Iverson has got a piece of a jump shot attempt from outside. Bryant trying to chase Iverson, who has a low pass into Camby, who draws the foul anyway. Pretty good tandem going on there between the first and second picks in the NBA draft last year. Allen Iverson and Marcus Camby.
Now Marcus Camby really had a very nice first half. Not only the 14 points, 5 rebounds, a couple shot blocks. Now this is a beautiful lob. Here comes Iverson. And Camby gets over the injury stick, gets healthy, builds up his upper body. This guy's going to be a whirlwind in this league.
He's rounding into form and has been a starter lately. Mentioned he's had a string of injuries, including a strained lower back, and that really got him underway in a slow fashion.
You know, he's so quick. The long arms, good defense, rebounder, shot blocker, can play all 3 positions on the front line.
I picked up by Walker. Here is Abdur-Rahim. Kobe Bryant guarded by Kerry Kittles, who throws up an air ball. Well, Kobe Bryant not bashful, is he? The 18-year-old.
Well, you know, at halftime he had 12 shot attempts, and that was 3 more than anyone else in the game.
He's 5-for-14 right now. Antoine Walker with a layup picks up a loose ball. 59-39, a 20-point lead for the East.
Nice.
And Bryant finally passes one behind his back to Abdur-Rahim, and a nifty one at that. You're seeing a lot of the all-time great 50 in the crowd, and they're all great. Here's Kerry Kittles trying to beat Bryant off the dribble, batted outside. Here's a Maloney and Abdur-Rahim, and the Vancouver Grizzly with the shot and the basket. 10 points now for Abdur-Rahim. Bryant with 13 and Knight with 9 are the 3 top scorers for the West.
That was Roy Rogers out of University of Alabama that blocked that shot to send him out on the break.
One of the best rookie shot blockers in the league is Dampier is fouled. Right now, let's go to Craig Sager, who's with Urban Magic Johnson. Craig?
Well, Dickens, we all know the NBA has not always been this popular. There was a time with declining TV ratings, a lack of charismatic players, and then along came Magic. And Irvin, I know you enjoy All-Star Weekend. It's been very busy for you this week. Tell us about your weekend.
Well, it's been busy because, first of all, on Thursday, I announced that we're building a Magic Johnson Theater here right after the winter. So this will be my fourth one. And then we got the 50 great players, and I got lucky. I guess somebody decided I was one of those guys. So we've been taking pictures and having parties, really talking with one another, getting autographs from each other. That's been the fun part. Everybody walking around getting each other's autographs. And I'm here to just see, like right now, seeing the rookie game, and I look forward to the slam dunk three-point contest and the game, of course, tomorrow, because these are our brightest stars, and these are the guys we look forward to carrying us on even after Michael is done.
And three of them, by the way, are Lakers. Also, he's been busy retrieving his mail from the hotel because Irvin Johnson and Ernie Johnson are similar, and he got a call from Ernie's wife saying that the report card was good news. Dick?
Yeah, that's good because Ernie was waiting for that report, and it was good news, and that's why you've seen Ernie in a good mood today. Abdur-Rahim has it deflected away. I just hope we get some passes to the latest Magic Johnson theater game.
There you go.
We saw a terrific block from Roy Rogers inside. You mentioned him before.
Yeah, you really like his talent. He's a quick rebound, a quick jumper, long arms to make it happen for you defensively.
Kobe Bryant with the basket and draws the foul as well. Remember, you can't foul out, but we do count fouls. Knight has three.
Lorenzen Wright, Steve Nash. Now you can see at 6'6", this guy's got some talent. Because not only does he have the range factor that you always have to guard against, but he also has the ability to take it off the dribble and go either way on you. So, and he'll eventually end up with a fairly decent shot once he penetrates into the painted area.
Good numbers for Kobe Bryant on the line as Lorenzen Wright replaces Travis Knight, who goes out of the game. Foul was on Potapenko, and here is Lorenzen Wright with the baby hook and his second basket.
Now Wright is starting to get major minutes with the Clippers at the starting position, and he has stepped up his game, and it's added to the Clippers' push for the playoffs, because if we started the playoffs today, the Clippers would be the eighth spot in the Western Conference.
Seventh pick was Lorenzen Wright. And he's averaging nearly 4.5 rebounds. Allen Iverson on a foray is fouled going to the hoop. And the foul is against Steve Nash.
You look at the Clippers, Dick, and you had Stanley Roberts injured again, probably going to have back surgery, the 7-foot center. And then you also had Brian Williams never re-signed. And there's their coach, Bill Fitch. And Bill has done, once again, an excellent job. And they're always that one major force in the pivot area away from securing that spot.
Here's Wright of the Clippers with a turnaround. Allen and Iverson crash the boards, and here is Ray Allen.
Nice.
So Allen and Iverson with Wallace, Walker, and Potapenko in the game right now. Out of bounds, it is still East ball. Iverson has 8 points, 8 assists, and 3 blocks. So he has really been the top player for the East, and maybe in the entire game. Nash trying to defend Iverson. Getting a little fancy out here, and he can do it. Off the rim, Wright with a quick pass to Fisher. 3-on-1 break, and Kobe Bryant doesn't get the layup, but draws the foul, and he'll shoot a pair.
He's fouling the 34, Ray Allen, his third.
Ray Allen committing the foul, and talking with some of the East players, asked them in the dressing room, what is your highlight of the year to a man? They said, playing against Michael Jordan and being on the same court as the Chicago Bulls, just playing in a game against the Bulls.
Well, it's not bad. I mean, Scotty, NBA first team selection the last 3 years. All defensive player along with that. When you say Scottie Pippen, you're going to get 15 to 25 points. You're probably going to get about 7 to 8 rebounds along with 7 assists.
In other words, a brilliant all-round player.
Well, I would think so. Those kind of numbers.
Antoine Walker foul going to the hoop.
Foul number 8, Kobe Bryant.
Kobe Bryant with the foul.
Now, this is just Iverson measuring Steve Nash right here. Let's face it. No one guy's going to stop him off the dribble penetration. He blew by Nash, got down into the lane, and then forced up a tough shot.
John Wallace going strong to the basket and is fouled. Wallace, who's out of Syracuse. Lorenzen Wright committing the foul. His second foul.
John Wallace at the line.
Now Wallace has made an excellent contribution in his rookie year with the Knicks. Now, this is the perfect example of being drafted on the first round and then have to fight for minutes because you're on a playoff team, a veteran team. Larry Johnson's in front of you. He's going to play 36 to 38 minutes. How much time is there for you to get in and get the job done?
But he has done an excellent job because he has long arms. He's a good offensive rebounder. Nash going to the hoop, lays it in. John Wallace, by the way, has played the fewest minutes of anyone on the Eastern team. A little bit too high for Iverson. Let's see if they call Nash with the foul, and they do. So a glimpse at the acceleration of Steve Nash out of Santa Clara. Want to remind you, still to come, we have plenty of activity here from the Gund Arena. The American Express $1 million shot coming up right after this game. The AT&T shootout and the Nestle Crunch slam dunk. Yeah, All-Star Saturday night.
Oops, bad pass.
Ray Allen working against Fisher and finally held by Fisher.
You look at this game and we know we have 16 players here. 15 guys that were drafted in the first round. Then you also have Matt Maloney, free agent, playing for Houston. But people forget there were 12 first-round draft picks who were not chosen to play in this game. That must be a very difficult thing for the player to swallow. Now, you know that Marbury and Samaki Walker are injured or they would be playing. Now, four of those 12 players are European players. And three of them decided not to play in the NBA. And then only one, you know, decided to come over here, and he's a backup down there at Miami, and let's talk about Miami. They only play 7-8 guys, and they're having a great season. So, you know, you look at it, and you say, well, what? Gee whiz, you know, why didn't some of those guys make it? It keeps coming down to minutes. Can you get minutes? Can you be seen? And then can you get shot attempts and get a chance to do your dance? That's what it's all about, minutes.
And as we said, Wallace has played the fewest minutes, 13 plus, but most of these players here, these rookies, have been in the 15 to 30 range. So they've had a chance to do their
dance.
Absolutely.
And that's why you say you never grade them in that first year because you never know what's going to happen. Isn't it interesting how many people think that John Stockton came in? Oh, look at these two old Knicks right there.
Red's looking more into the crowd at those two than he is on his own bench, I think, right now. Red Olds.
Walt Frazier and Dave the Busher, two of the best.
There's Red Holtzman. And don't forget ex-Senator Bill Bradley and Willis Reed, along with Earl the Pearl Monroe. Great era for the New York Knicks. Kobe Bryant has 18 points, and he can't save this one. Bryant has 18, Abdur-Rahim 12 are the high scorers for the West. Way behind the East, Marcus Camby with 15 and Antoine Walker with 11 are the top scorers for the East. Ray Allen fires over Fisher for three. Wallace keeps it alive, and Fisher just strips him of the ball, steps on the line. But credit Derek Fisher with pretty good hustle against the bigger guy.
Yeah, well, the Lakers really like his talent. He's a very savvy point guard. He's a true point guard, and he can finish. And that's very important. And when you play with the Lakers, the most important thing is you must be able to feed the post.
Speaking of the post, Potapico of the Cavaliers with a fall away. Wallace, offensive rebound. And here comes Kobe Bryant. He's got Nash, Abdur-Rahim, Lorenzen Wright, and Derek Fisher. Nash misses a banker. And here comes Ray Allen. 65-54. The lead is 11. At one point, it was 20 for the East.
These games are played peaks and valleys.
That's right. Teams have runs, don't they?
Now, there's a guy who put up some numbers during his day. Rick Barry and his sons are playing in the league. And Rick was one of the all-time great small forwards ever to play this game. And when you talk about the best front court passers, you have to put them in the same sentence with Larry Bird and now Charles Barkley, taking double teams and playing the people.
And the shortest of the, he was 6'7". Barkley's the shortest of the forwards that pass so well. Fisher winds up on the floor as he missed the layup. Kittles getting it back to Ray Allen, a couple of former Big East players. Kittles at Villanova and Allen at UConn. And Allen is fouled and will have a timeout called by Red Auerbach's East squad. Red Auerbach's East 65, Red Holtzman's West 54, with 7:50 remaining in the second half.
This is a guy thing, right?
Schick brings you the shaving system for sensitive skin.
Is this a sensitive part?
Designed to give a smooth shave with less irritation. Schick. Tracer FX.
The sensitive type? I like that.
Designed for the man with sensitive skin. Schick Tracer FX.
He wants a new Mazda. She wants a used Mazda. So how did they find happiness? They went to Cable Dahmer Mazda in Independence, because Cable Dahmer Mazda emphasizes both new and used. A big selection of new Mazda trucks, minivans, and the Miata, and a big selection of high-quality late-model used cars, foreign and domestic, with nice people to help you. So if you're looking for new, but you'd rather buy used, or vice versa, see both new and used at Cable Dahmer Mazda on the Miracle Mile, Nolan Road, Independence.
Well, you got me here to the sale. See anything you like?
Right here.
We don't need a TV.
I know, but I'd love to have that GE range.
Welcome to Clark's Appliance. You know, we have a big sale going on.
But I bet you don't have GE appliances on sale.
I bet we do. This is Clark's Appliance. What kind of sale would it be without GE?
At these prices, we could afford a whole new GE kitchen.
The smart time to buy a GE appliance is now. The smart place to buy is Clark's Appliance.
Back at the Schick rookie game, the East lead cut to 11. It was 20. Want to remind you, still to come, the American Express million-dollar shot, the AT&T shootout, and the Nestle Crunch slammed up. But right now, Cheryl Miller is with Zeke, Isaiah Thomas.
Thanks a lot, Dick. First of all, let's talk a little bit about your player, Marcus Camby, playing extremely well, 15 points.
Marcus is playing well. You know, I think what he's come here to do is kind of show everybody that he was the best rookie, and I think he's trying to establish himself. I think he's got like 15 points and like, you know, 8 rebounds already. So you know, let's just see how the rest of the game goes.
Isaiah, what is it like being here with the 50 greatest athletes in the NBA?
I think I'm the biggest fan of all of them. I had my book out, and I went around. I got everybody's autograph, and I had never met Wilt Chamberlain before. And I got a chance to meet him and sit and talk with him, and God, is he big. You know, I didn't realize how big he was, but the 7 foot, and then I think there's Will.
And he still looks like he can go a little bit.
He is big. I mean, he's a different kind of 7 feet. He not the Akeem Olajuwon, Patrick Ewing type of 7 feet. He Will Chamberlain 7 feet.
All right, Isaiah, enjoy the game. Let's go back to you, Dick.
Can you believe that Isaiah Thomas never met Will Chamberlain?
That's a stunner. First of all, it was nice to hear the happiness and the enjoyment that Isaiah's here, and how they are all universal, and the fact that they're getting autographs.
Yeah.
That's terrific.
Every player, I mean, they were like kids getting autographs. I mean, there was Billy Cunningham, John Havlicek going over to Elgin Baylor. Amazing.
Let's go back to Will. I mean, you think that Michael Jordan has scored over 50 points 38 times, and then think of Will. He only did it 118 times.
Well, that's like the old triple-double.
Yeah, right.
Oscar Robertson did it for a lifetime.
That's right.
Oscar tutoring Jim Valenti for his million-dollar shot. That's going to be coming up soon. We have 7:15 remaining in the second half. The East leading the West 67-55. We've had 3 close games in the rookie contest, and this one right now is 12. It was 20. Here's Derek Fisher feeding Maloney. Maloney off the rim, throws an air ball, and unable to save it is Travis Knight. So it'll be the East ball. Leading scorers for the East: Marcus Camby with 15, Antoine Walker with 11. Every player has scored for the East, and Kobe Bryant with 18, Abdul Rahim has 12. Camby, by the way, also with 11 off the glass. Kittle's trying to beat Maloney. Dampier comes out of nowhere and slams it through. Eric Dampier.
Hey, Eric Dampier is a big five. Oh, boy. We almost had 3 media people on that one. That ball was a rope. Now just keep an eye to the right of your screen. You're going to see Dampier come in here and take that one and slam it down.
Indiana Pacers trying to get back into action in the playoff race in the Eastern Conference. They need a healthy Rick Smits. Here's Iverson working against Derek Fisher. Stop and spins and hits. Allen Iverson now with 10 points, and he has a bundle of assists so far in this game. He's got 8 of them. Fisher goes low to Wright, right against Dampier, just beat him. What quickness did Lorenzen Wright show there?
Oh, that was beautiful. That was a great drop step. He just kept that going.
14-point lead now, 71-57 East. Camby for three, hits it. Marcus Camby, who is 11% from downtown. Lenny Wilkins looking on. He's got a big one with the Chicago Bulls next Friday.
The Hawks are playing great. Whenever they get Allen Henderson back to help out that second unit, watch out.
They'll be on TNT in a big week of games on Turner Sports next week. Here is Iverson in a great pass that time. Iverson has 12. And the West wants a timeout. Maybe too much to overcome. Marcus Camby. Tell you, he's looking good as a passer as well as a guy who can hit from the perimeter a little bit.
What I like about his game is he's just telling everyone, you know, that, hey, I'm not just an inside guy, a post up, a slasher. I run the lanes. I can do everything. And now I just showed you guys at the table that I can make a three. He has 18 points, 12 rebounds, 3 assists.
And he's healthy for the first time this year.
That's absolutely right. That's a major point with Camby.
Let's listen in now to Red Auerbach. I don't know what we're going to hear because I know he has a cold and doesn't have much of a voice. He says, I never get a cold, but I have one now.
Hey, look, we're not going to get that shit, man. You know nothing. Hey, this is an all-star game. We ain't giving nobody nothing.
Arnold Red Auerbach, who is still the president of the Boston Celtics. And, he has had a problem with his voice, as had our director Lonnie Dale. But Lonnie Dale, with the miracle medical help, sounds great to us anyway. And Red Holtzman on the other end. I wonder if Red will light up a victory cigar after this game. That's in the days when they allowed smoking in buildings. I want to remind you, next week, the Detroit Pistons and sensational Grant Hill appear twice. The Miami Heat and the Orlando Magic. Miami with Alonzo Mourning and Tim Hardaway. Orlando with Penny Hardaway. That's the lineup next week on TNT and TBS. And the Bulls and Hawks next Friday. Doug Collins has got the Pistons with the third best record in the league right now.
He's done an outstanding job, and when you consider that they do not have what you would refer to as a big center, that they've been able to maneuver, you know, and play with three forwards and get the job done. It's an outstanding defensive job and great organization by the coaching staff.
Doug Collins talking to Grant Hill's mother and the wife of Calvin Hill, former NFL great. There's Grant. Fisher driving the hoop is foul. Derek Fisher, who replaced Stephon Marbury of the Minnesota Timberwolves, will go to the line with 5:29 remaining in the second half. The East led by 15 after the first half, extended their lead to 20, and can establish. Well, they have a 19-point lead now. Fisher misses the first free throw, and it went through. We understand. We're getting this communique from. Fisher makes both of them. First one looked like didn't look like it went through, but Fisher's got them both, and it's 76-59. Here's Iverson.
Antoine Walker saying, come on, I got Kobe Bryant on me. This is the smallest guy who has played me defensively in 2 months.
Double team, and he throws it away. Maloney with a quick pass to Fisher. Iverson trying for the block, and the basket counts. And Iverson will help up Derek Fisher because he's got to like the move that Fisher showed there.
Anytime you're going to have someone run you down or come for the shot block, always come up on the other side of the rim. See, that was beautiful. Not only does he get a good chance to give a little reverse spin on that baby hook shot, but then the defender is going to come over your back
he got a chance for 3 points.
8 points and four assists for Derek Fisher, who got another pat on the back from Allen Iverson, who was really impressed by the move. So a three-point play by Fisher. And the lead is 14 for the East as we get down to the five-minute mark. Iverson into Camby. Knight doing a good job against him. Camby, not to be denied, misses it, and Iverson follows. Allen Iverson now with 14 points, and it's a 78-62 game. Iverson from Georgetown and the Philadelphia 76ers now. Nice. Fisher open for three. Good pass from Travis Knight.
Excellent ball movement. As soon as Knight had the double team, he found Fisher on a diagonal pass.
Lead is 13 with under 4.5 minutes to go. Terry Kittle's trying to post up against Matt Maloney. Camby, long rebound. And here comes the West. They're trailing. And a 4-on-1 break. Fisher lays it in. So Derek Fisher, doing a lot of the damage lately, has scored the last 8 points for the West. And they've cut the lead again to 11. 4:02 to go and a foul. And now they say a double dribble is a violation. Ray Allen will come into the game for the East, and the West making a run here. And a timeout called by Red Auerbach's East team with 4:01 remaining in the second half. 78-67, the East leading.
Time to think fast as we celebrate the NBA 150 with another edition of Flashback. Can you name the player that has played in the most regular season games ever?
Well, Jim Valenti, the 49-year-old from Bradenton Beach, Florida, who's out of Anna Maria Island, Florida, has been tutored by one of the greatest, Oscar Robertson, has made a lot of attempts.
How many shots do I get at this?
Yeah. Only one, Jim, when it really counts. Only one. You know, it's interesting to talk about the respect that these young players may have or not have for the veterans, but you can't compare eras as far as athletic ability, and you really can't compare them as far as celebrity, because NBA players, now worldwide celebrities, is Ice Gervin, who's one of the great shooters. So now we have a different kind of characteristic of players coming out and playing ball than we used to.
Yeah, for all of the people who are saying that they are immature and they have no respect, well, what will happen is, if you don't play to your potential and you do not make the all-star teams and you constantly play on losing teams, it fades quickly. And what will happen is you will be lost in the shuffle as your three-year contract wears off, the shoe contracts go, the commercials go, and all of a sudden now you just become another player in this league. And so it happens quickly, Dick.
Yeah, and you got to produce, and they know that. Roy Rogers with the lay-in, and it's 78-69, a 9-point lead. So the West with a big challenge here against the East with 3:35 to go. Iverson with a scoop shot. Allen Iverson is always there to make the big pass, the big block, or the big basket whenever the East needs it. And another former 76er, the doctor, watching. Let's check in with Craig Sager.
Well, Dick, everybody's getting autographs this weekend, but the best collection belongs to one of the top 50 players of all time, Clyde Drexler. You're having a lot of fun.
Hey, this is like being a kid in a candy store. I've been an avid NBA fan for many, many years. And I'm, you know, this occasion is one of the most historic occasions in the history of the NBA. And so I'm having a great time.
What's your most prized autograph?
Well, the greatest of all times. He's right here in front of me. Signed a couple of my books for my young children, and I couldn't be happier.
Well, is it true? Would you like to tell Clyde how many points you would score if you played in the game today? How many points do you average?
Well, you got to understand, with the rules of the day, with the offense, not allowed to touch you, can't come in and put three or four guys around you when you don't have the ball. Probably about 65 or 70 might be a good thing, you know.
All right, thanks, guys. Back to Dick and Hubie.
And that's conservative, I bet. Yeah. Right?
Well, you know what's interesting, Dick? Every time they say the strongest man ever to play the game is Will Chamberlain, probably Artis Gilmer second. And everyone is unanimous about that. When you look back over a period of time, at one time, Wilt had over 50 offensive records in this league. And there's the guy who didn't do a bad job either.
Oh,
he doesn't have enough fingers to carry all the rings.
Right, you know, in the days before Larry Bird and Magic Johnson, the Bill Russell Will Chamberlain battle was the one everyone came to see in the 50s and 60s. Kobe Bryant on the free throw line. He'll be shooting the three. He was fouled beyond the arc. Bryant with 21 points, 8 rebounds, and 7 of 10 from the line. 82-72, the East front with 3:05 remaining. East had a 20-point lead at one point here in the second half, and the West trying to make a late run at things.
You remember that famous racehorse, Silky Sullivan?
Yeah,
right? He used to give everyone spot of about half the track and then come on from like 40 lengths back. That's what the West is trying to do here in the next 3 minutes of this game.
And it'll be interesting to see how far they come as Kobe Bryant from Lower Merion High School in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, hits both free throws. He now has 23 points. Red Holtzman urging on the West to make that run with 3 minutes to go. The lead is now down to 8 for the East. Allen Iverson spinning his way, going over Maloney. And Matt Maloney, the rebound. Fisher is down court.
Nice.
And Derek Fisher, oh, with a great move, lays it in, and it's a 6-point game, 82-76, with still enough time remaining.
That was a pretty catch and a beautiful move.
How about Fisher with 16 points, 12 here in the second half?
Done a great job.
Allen off the glass, and Roy Rogers fouls Antoine Walker from behind.
Roy Rogers.
Now, when you realize that Derek Fisher would not have been in the game,
number 10.
But Stephon Marbury came up with the injury. Now, this is just about. Now, just watch this move while he's in the air. Nice. Let that defender go right on by.
Go up, change hands, and now Antoine Walker makes the free throw. Walker, 57% free throw shooter, so that was a big one for the East, as John Wallace will come into the game, placing Vitali Potapenko of the Cleveland Cavaliers. Those are Walker's numbers. He's had a good game tonight. Great balance by the East. Everyone scored. And there was more of the 57% shooting variety. Larry Bird winces at that attempt.
We had that the door open and that wind just blew through there. That's all.
Right.
That's all.
So everyone has scored for the West as well. 83-76, 7-point lead, 2:20 to go. Abdul Rahim blocked to the baseline now by Antoine Walker. Plenty of time on the shot clock. That hasn't bothered anyone today. And Derek Fisher deflected. Kobe Bryant works his way in and scores. Kobe Bryant didn't even have control of it at first. Has 25 points. Here's a Philadelphian in his pro career. Billy Cunningham, 83-78. Wallace misses a three. Walker with a big offensive rebound and lays it in. That stops the surge a little bit with 1:50 to go in the fourth, in the second half. Two halves today. 85-78. Bryant throws it away into the hands of Ray Allen. Bad time for a turnover if the West is to make a run. Wallace from Antoine Walker.
Look out.
Here is Kobe Bryant, and they're going to call a two-shot foul as Iverson fouls Bryant.
The foul is on Allen Iverson, his second.
We'll give you Bryant's last bucket here. This is just a nice move. Going down the middle, gets hit.
All right, shoot.
So Kobe Bryant, at this point with the Lakers, is the backup point guard. Lakers coming off maybe their biggest win of the year last Wednesday night without Shaquille O'Neal, defeating the Chicago Bulls by 16 at the Forum.
Eldon Campbell was magnificent, getting 34 points in the pivot, established the inside game, and then the perimeter people, Van Exel, Eddie Jones, and Horry played sensational. Put up big numbers.
87-80, the lead is 7. Under a minute and a half remaining, 126, 17 on the shot clock for the East. Allen guarded by Matt Maloney. And Allen will shoot over Maloney. And into the hands of Abdul Rahim, pushing the ball up court. Abdul Rahim does it all the way on a solo shot. And the lead is down to 5. It was at 20 early here in the second half.
First time I saw Abdul Rahim was in the semifinals of the state tournament at Georgia Tech.
in Atlanta, Georgia.
He convinced you.
Oh, he was spectacular, Dick. Spectacular. And you just knew he was going to be a star. What talent that young man
is.
And here he comes right now. He's just going to step it out. He could handle back then. And you just think about it now. This would only be his second year out of high school. First time that a freshman ever was player of the year in the Pac-10 last year at the University of California.
You're looking at a lot of UCLA years even after freshmen were allowed to play. Iverson makes a one out of two. It was a penalty situation. Iverson now with 17 points. The lead is 6, 88-82, under a minute, 51 plus. And running, 16 on the shot clock. Here is Fisher going for three. Lorenzen Wright stepped on the line and turns it over. So the East has it.
They needed that one. Matt Maloney put that one down, would have made it a three-point game.
You see, you're used to these close games. Yeah. You want a one-point or two-point game every time. Now, you know, some years we're not going to have that. Derek Fisher trips Allen Iverson, who goes sprawling. And he'll shoot two with 36.4 seconds remaining. Allen Iverson playing an outstanding game, and Arnold Red Auerbach nursing a cold. Still works out. Lives in Washington, D.C. The greatest of the greats.
Not only a great coach with the 9 rings, but one of the greatest general managers in the history of this league. Knew how to keep the cupboard with talent. Knew when to get rid of players a year before they went down and their talent diminished. He had a knack.
Antoine Walker of the Celtics with a steal in the basket will ice this one. 10-point lead with 31.4 seconds, and Kobe Bryant is fouled by Antoine Walker. And the ability to pick up players from the scrap heaps, so to speak. Don Nelson being one of them, and there were many others. Emmitt Bryant helped them win a championship. You can go down the line. There's Don Nelson, who's the new general manager of the Dallas Mavericks.
Kobe Bryant
returning to the NBA Wars.
How about taking a chance on the big redhead, Bill Walton? After all of his operations to this beat. And then that great team, the Boston Celtics, one of the 10 best teams, 1986.
There is Bill Walton.
That wasn't a bad team. They were 40-1 at home.
Not bad.
And if you play 500 ball on the road, you'll have the best record in the league easily.
Not a bad club.
Kobe Bryant, with the free throws, now has 29 points, and that is the most ever in a rookie game. So the 18-year-old from Lower Merion High School in Philadelphia establishes a rookie scoring record with 29, and a foul is committed by Fisher.
2 years ago, Eddie Jones, currently a player with the Los Angeles Lakers out of Temple University, won the MVP in this game with 25 points.
The first MVP was Penny Hardaway, who talked with Cheryl Miller earlier. And last year, Damon Stoudemire was the MVP of this game and then went on to win Rookie of the Year honors in the league. Iverson misses both free throws. Abdul-Rahim. And before he can get it up court, a timeout called by Red Holtzman and the West squad. You're allowed two timeouts in the second half for each team, one in the first.
Now, I'm going to tell you, Red is coaching over here.
Yes.
Not only caused it, shorten the game, give us a timeout, move the ball half court. Then he went over, did a little bickering with the referee.
Who said that?
Those two titles were not enough for Red Holtzman.
There you go. That's right.
He wants to come out on top in the rookie game as well. It'll be an uphill climb, however. 92-84 with 21.7 seconds remaining. Well, still to come on All-Star Saturday night here on TNT, the American Express $1 Million Shot. 49-year-old Jim Valenti of Bradenton Beach, Florida, has been tutored by Oscar Robertson. Will try to make a three-point shot for $1 million. He gets $10,000 if he misses. And then the AT&T shootout and the Nestle Crunch slam dunk. So we have a great deal still to come here in this All-Star weekend in Cleveland. Let's take a look again at the competitors in the shootout. There's Tim Legler, who is the defending champion.
Just recently off the injured list, playing with the Washington Bullets. It's nice to see him back.
He hasn't played a game this season, but he can go out there and fire away and defend his title, and that's what he'll be trying to do against some pretty impressive company. Well, the West has used their timeouts. Obviously, the three-point shot. Oh, they're looking for an easy two, and Nash gets it. They caught the East sleeping and got a two in a hurry. It's 20.1. It's 92-86. And there is Antoine Walker, who is underneath. A little late to trade hoops. Nash feeding Kobe Bryant. And 31 points for Kobe Bryant. He has long since established a rookie scoring record for this game. And out of bounds, with 9.7 seconds remaining, it'll be East ball. John Wallace will inbound. The East is going to come out on top. Last year they won 94-92. Ray Allen is fouled by Bryant with 5.3 seconds to go. Kobe Bryant, 31 points and 8 rebounds, and he came out firing tonight.
Ray Allen to shoot.
What do you show this year this evening? Great athletic talent. He has all the dimensions of being a star. They are now using him, giving him more minutes, meaningful minutes, with the Los Angeles Lakers. And when you realize that the Lakers are trying to lead their division, it's a great tribute to his talent to be his age and making this contribution where every game is a big game.
Playing in the rookie game, and then, of course, someday hopes to be in the All-Star game itself. And that's going to be coming your way tomorrow at 6 o'clock Eastern on NBC. The NBA All-Star game. Michael Jordan, of course, leading the way. Here is Travis Knight feeding into Abdur-Rahim. Final seconds. And Abdur-Rahim hits a three at the buzzer. And the East prevails nonetheless. And Allen Iverson with an outstanding game. Even Rick Barry's young son applauds these rookies. The final score, the East 96, the West 91. In a high-scoring affair, Allen Iverson. Big star tonight as a scorer, shot blocker, and passer. Had 19 points and 9 assists. We'll be right back.
Usually the more gizmos you want, the more money you gotta spend. Then there's a Chevrolet Cavalier. It gives you a lot of the same gizmos that make expensive cars easy to live with. If you forget to lock your doors, the Cavalier is still protected by a gizmo called a theft deterrent system. If you leave your dome light on, it turns it off. Get the car that's easy to own, a Cavalier. Genuine Chevrolet. The cars more Americans trust.
Get 3.9% APR financing on Cavalier now through February 17th.
Okay, guys, to work on your dunking skills, we've brought in the experts.
Now there's a great deal on McDonald's Chicken McNuggets.
I want to see some crisp passing.
Grab six while they're just 99 cents.
And then take it to the home.
Nine are only 159.
You call that a dunk? Easy, Grant.
Right now, 20 McNuggets are just 2.99. Perfect with America's favorite fries.
Watch my slam. Yes!
That's a dunk.
McDonald's Chicken McNuggets, America's favorite way to dunk.
I think everyone in the arena thought he was going to pass.
My uncles played ball. My father played ball. Basketball is in my blood. I'm still a leader in my own small way.
Oh, I'm the king. Oh, I'm the king.
Make no mistake. You are the king. And the king lives in the castle. And his word is law.
Does everyone have email but you? AT&T can deliver it to you through the internet. AT&T, nobody makes it easier to catch the wave. Worried that no one will visit your website? AT&T can drive customers right to your door. AT&T, nobody makes it easier to catch the wave.
And the final score in the Schick rookie game here at Gund Arena in Cleveland, the West losing to the East 96-91, putting on a late spurt but falling short and losing by 5 points. And the MVP of the Schick rookie game is Allen Iverson of the Philadelphia 76ers, who had 19 points, 9 assists, and 3 block shots, presented with the trophy. Steve Lutz of Schick. So Allen Iverson, who came out passing, very aggressive play tonight.
Well, he definitely made a lot of things happen in that first half, Nick.
Not to be denied, misses it at high.
And I think that what the voters voted for was the penetration, passing off for the 8 assists at halftime, making things happen, and then just creating for everybody. And then he said, you know what, it's my time to score. And he did score.
So despite the 31 by Kobe Bryant, an all-time rookie high, it was Allen Iverson with the all-round play, and right now he's with Craig Sager. Craig?
Well, congratulations, Allen. Dick and Hubie were talking about how this rookie game is a proving ground, a chance to seize the opportunity. What were your thoughts going in? What did you want to accomplish?
I just figured everybody, you know, felt that I was going to come in and try to shoot up all the balls. But I wanted to just come in and get my teammates involved so they can get a good feel for the game. You know, it was a large crowd out here, and it's an all-star game. And I just wanted them to feel comfortable and just get them a couple easy layups. And they was catching my passes, and they played great. Without them, I wouldn't be holding this trophy right now.
Kobe Bryant had 31 points, but as you know, winning is the important thing. With only 12 wins so far for the Sixers at the break, what do you hope to accomplish in the second half?
We just want to just play harder than we played the first half. You know, hopefully get all guys back from injuries, get those guys on the floor and start playing. I feel good about the way our team is competing, you know, night after night. You know, we're not getting blown out of games, but we just got to learn how to win at the end of the game. You know, part of that comes from me, you know, being young, coming in this league and stepping in, playing a point guard position. I have a lot of learning to do, and I have Mo Cheeks right on the left of me every game, and he's helped me out a lot.
Great memories for you this weekend, but this morning, headlines of the paper, legends take Iverson, young players to task. Would you please clarify your position and how you feel about the 50 greatest players in the stands today?
Without those players, it wouldn't be no Allen Iverson. You know, those guys paved the way for me. They made me want to play. When I saw Michael Jordan growing up, I always wanted to, you know, be in the situations that he used to be in when he first came to Chicago. And I watched Barkley play and those guys, and they made me want to be a basketball player. I have a lot of respect for those guys. I have a lot of respect for the NBA, period. And I'm just glad to be here. It's a dream come true.
Congratulations. Enjoy the weekend. Let's go back to Dick and Hubie.
All right, Craig, thanks for asking that, and a great response for Allen Iverson, who told the country and the world how he feels about those veterans, right from Allen Iverson himself. Meanwhile, what about Jim Valenti, who's getting ready for his big moment, Hubie?
Well, $1 million, pressure shot. If he misses, he gets $10,000. There are only 180 countries watching this game, never mind 15 million people here in the United States. So I would say there's a little bit of pressure on him.
And his wife, Kathy, celebrating her 47th birthday the night of this shot. She's admitting how old she is, and maybe that'll be good luck. And you know what? This has been a big week for people attempting million-dollar shots. Let's go to the Pro Bowl, where Lance Allstott, kicking a 35-yard field goal attempt for $1 million.
Good.
Made it through. So Lance Allstott won $1 million, kicking a 35-yard field goal at the Pro Bowl in Honolulu. And now it'll be Jim Valenti is going to try to hit a three-point basket for $1 million. It could be $1 million week, UB.
Yeah, it's great. And Oscar Robertson keeps telling him, flex your legs, flex your legs.
I would listen to Oscar Robertson.
I would hope so.
All right. So Jim Valenti will try the American Express $1 million shot when we come back to Cleveland in just a moment. We know you're not going to go away for this.
NBA All-Star Saturday Night on TNT is brought to you by Isuzu, equipment for real life, and by Wendy's Delicious Spicy Chicken Sandwich.
A 360 double pump tomahawk jam.
If you're into slam dunks, maybe you'd better stick to watching the Nestle Crunch Slam Dunk Contest on TNT. To catch Slam Dunk Mania, get to a store, buy Nestle candy, collect the wrappers, and get free NBA gear. The Nestle Crunch Slam Dunk Contest, February 8th on TNT. Check for the time in your area. It's crunch time, baby.
Hey, Valerie, it's me. Give me a call when you get in, okay?
Bye.
Val, hey, Where are you? Are you mad at me? Listen, whatever it is, it's my fault, okay? It's not you. It's me.
Right now, for $199 a month for 24 months and $1,943 due at lease signing, you can get away from it all in a new Isuzu Rodeo. But make sure you let your loved ones know where you're headed first.
It's because I still live with my mother, isn't it?
Hungry? Follow me. At the station, we've got 12 great restaurants to choose from, more than anyone else. Real Italian food. Mwah. Delicious Mexican. The freshest seafood this side of Louisiana. And the all-you-can-eat feast around the world. 5 restaurants in one. Great food and great fun. The station always gives you more. Let's go!
Uh-oh, just when you need them, your wipers never work. Don't wait till it's too late. Get Triple Edge wipers today. The patented Triple Edge outperforms all other wipers. Look, Triple Edge clears, cleans, then dries. Nothing works like Triple Edge. And they're made from Dow Corning silicone, so they last. Wipe away snow and ice. See clearly through that heavy downpour with Triple Edge. Get your Triple Edge wipers today, and we'll also include Triple Edge washer fluid absolutely free. All this for just $19.95, so call now.
Right about now, the pulse is beginning to quicken, the palms beginning to sweat, the butterflies beginning to feel more like condors, because soon the spotlight will be shining, the PA announcer will do the introductions, and a sellout crowd will watch one shooter take one shot. For $1 million. Money! It's the American Express $1 million shot. And I know what you're saying at home. Oh, come on, that thing's a piece of cake. I make it in my backyard all the time. It's just your basic NBA three-pointer, 22 feet away. But I'm telling you, when you're in front of that sellout crowd, it's a different story. A few tips to remember. Got to use your legs. Got to have that good rotation. Got to have that sweet release. Kind of like this. Yeah. They're loving it, and it was even more than 22 feet. I'll tell you something. It's easy money when you're in the virtual arena. Could be a different story in the real thing. Let's go back to gun.
All right, Ernie, if you were attempting it, they'd be backing up the Brinks truck the way your style is all set. Now we're set for the American Express $1 million shot, and right now let's send it over to the public address announcer, Jeff Shreve.
Here's our contestant. Jim Valente, accompanied by his coach, Oscar Robertson, his wife, and their son and daughter. Jim has an added incentive tonight. It's his wife, Catherine's birthday. Jim will now take one shot from the three-point line. If he makes the shot, he will win $1 million courtesy of American Express. Okay, Jim, take your best shot.
Jim Valenti, how many times has he practiced this? Off to the left. Well, he'll have to settle for $10,000. No big birthday present for Kathy.
Since January 23rd, an hour and a half a day, practice.
Craig Sager is over there with Jim Valenti right now.
Well, Jim, I know you practiced this shot. Physically, you were ready. Yeah. What was it like? How did you feel at the time? What went wrong?
I think I just pushed it a little to the right. Just didn't get those legs in it, like Oscar told me 300 times. But hey, listen, I put it up there. I thought I could get it in.
You pushed it to the right. Do you think that was from tired, practicing too much? Push it to the side, or do you think possibly just sweaty palms? And?
Well, I don't know. You know, I think the 15, 20-minute break kind of slowed me down a little bit. But, you know, got a little tight.
What were your thoughts last night preparing for the shot? I know you told me you thought you were going to make it. Did you sleep well? What was this morning and today like?
I dreamt I made this shot all night long. So, you know, it's just, hey, you get out here, it's a little bit different than playing in the high school gym, you know?
How was the experience, though, getting $10,000, getting tips from Oscar Robertson, enjoying the weekend?
Yeah. I'll tell you, the coaching has been terrific. This guy is superb. The American Express people have treated us like a million-dollar winner all along.
You didn't spend the $1 million already, did you?
No, but I'm happy with the $10,000 birthday present.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Thanks for being with us. Thanks for your cooperation all week. Now let's go back to the set.
You know, what's interesting, Hubie, is that he said he pushed it to the right, and we saw the replay three times, and it looked like he went to the left.
American Express, yeah, and the National
Basketball. Yeah, he just didn't get enough backspin on it. But let's face it, we're talking about a tremendous amount of pressure.
Right.
I mean, it looks easy. I know on television a few weeks ago, I saw a guy make three shots in a major competition from half court, three in a row. I mean, I almost fell off my couch. But you know, no one in attendance. Here we only had, like we said, 180 countries. 20,000 in here, and then maybe another 15 to 20 million watching across the country.
And it's $10,000, and if you're a fan, you get to work with Oscar Robertson, and that's pretty good. And presenting the check to Jim Valenti for $10,000, Andy Wing, the vice president and general manager of promotions and events for American Express. Well, he missed the three-point shot, gave it his all, and he's still smiling. Right now, let's go upstairs to Ernie Johnson.
All right, thank you, Dick. Probably got people in 180 countries saying, man, I could have made that. We're at the halfway point now of All-Star Saturday. So far, we've seen the Schick rookie game. You saw the East beat the West 96-91. Allen Iverson was the MVP, 19 points and 9 assists. He hit 7 out of 11 from the field. Of course, the American Express million-dollar shot. Jim Valenti joins the ranks of Mike Hoban and Demetrius Houston before him. Don't get the million, but they do get $10,000. Coming up next, it's the AT&T shootout, and still to come, the Nestle Crunch slam dunk here at Gund Arena. Covering tonight's festivities, the Goodyear blimp Spirit, housed 30 miles from here in Akron. We've got a lot more to go, folks. Keep it right here.
Tomorrow.
If there's ever anything I can do for you, he'll be sure to let you know.
Bounty hunters challenge Robin to a race against death.
I can handle this.
And let you have all the fun.
Take aim with the new adventures of Robin Hood. Tomorrow morning at 10 on TNT.
Beautiful women, exotic locations, and me.
Watch Sports Illustrated Swimsuit 97. Premiering 2 weeks from tonight at 9 on TNT.
All right, ladies, take 5.
Oh, ow, I think I pulled something.
Maybe later, dude.
Hey, Dave.
Cool.
Go for a ride sometime.
Maybe later.
Looking to warm up this winter? Come to Wendy's. Our spicy chicken is a whole breast fillet seasoned with Dave's own blend of pepper and spices. It's got a spicy hit that'll make you feel warm all over.
Dave. Hey, Dave. Man, where you been?
I think I was at the beach.
Come in for a Wendy's spicy chicken sandwich today.
Does everyone have email but you? AT&T can deliver it to you through the internet. AT&T, nobody makes it easier to catch the wave. Worried that no one will visit your website? AT&T can drive customers right to your door. AT&T, nobody makes it easier to catch the wave.
Continues in Cleveland, where shortly the three-point specialist will take center stage at the AT&T shootout. It's become an all-star weekend classic. Now, in the annals of rock and roll, this was a classic weekend. Woodstock. I may be a little overdressed. Sure, there have been imitators, but Woodstock set the standard. just like these classic performers have, from Satchmo to Zeke to the Supremes. And there's the Hall of Fame royalty, the Queen of Soul, Aretha Franklin. And the King of Rock and Roll. Hey, Elvis has entered the virtual building. Now, when you're talking classics in an NBA sense, you may want to start with Larry Bird, owner of that uncanny shooting touch from the outside, that unshakable confidence. It brought him 3 shootout titles, setting a lofty goal for all those who have followed. Guys like last year's winner, Tim Legler of the Washington Bullets, who beat Dennis Scott in the finals. Now it's time to roll out the ball racks, step back behind the arc, and let it fly just like Larry Legend. It's the AT&T Shootout.
Oh, Leonard Skinner, turn it up. It is time for the AT&T Shootout from Gund Arena. We've had shift change down there courtside. Dick and Hubie can now just sit and watch. Bob Neal, Doc Rivers, Reggie Theus at your service. Take it away, guys.
Thank you, Ernie. And, if this plane's been flying smooth with Dick and Hubie, we're going to do some rolls, some reverse loops.
That's right.
Because we're about time for the three-point shootout and the slam dunk competition. Of course, on my far right, Reggie Theus, Doc Rivers here in the middle. These two fellas have had a lot of experience with shooting the long-range bomb and with slam dunking themselves. Let's start off, first of all, though, with the three-point shootout. Yeah. And yesterday, though neither one of these players ever competed in the three-point shootout themselves, you got a chance, both of you, to have a run at it under a clock to get a real feel for it, Reggie.
Well, Bob, I felt good yesterday because now I'm 2-0 against my counterpart, killed Doc yesterday in the three-point contest. But what I found out is that it takes a lot of strength and stamina to do the three-point contest. You should have to take each rack about 9 seconds. If you go more than that, you will never finish. And you have to be extremely focused, guys, because they have to hit that back of the rim and get it all net. And a lot of guys shoot a lot of different ways on the three-point balls.
Doc, you must have a reply.
Not much of a reply.
No comment.
Excellent. I tell you what, not only concentration, but I think composure is the key. You can't panic if you start missing shots early. You have to keep going with it. And like Steve Kerr said to me, he said, rhythm is the important factor. If I have my rhythm, you have a chance of winning.
All right, let's go to the slam dunk competition. We'll follow the shootout. And what you notice there is a difference from the focus to an event of creativity and a different mindset, would you say?
Oh, yeah, this is not a concentration event. It's an event of power, of charisma, and of style. You know, anybody can dunk.
Yeah.
It's not that you can dunk. It's what you bring with your dunk.
Well, maybe not anybody. Like, for instance, guess which one of the three of us can.
Maybe with a step ladder over there.
That's true. Yeah.
I tell you what, it's all about style. It's all about getting the fans involved in it. You got to come out. It's a show. You got to come out and show your stuff. Rhythm, getting up, a little bit of this, a little bit of that, and then what you do after the dunk is what's important, because the crowd has a big influence on the judges.
And it's really interesting. It may be a statement about the game today. First and second year players exclusively in the slam dunk. The older players, like Dale Ellis, for example, who's 36 years old, and twice as old as Kobe Bryant, who's in the slam dunk, is in the three-point shootout. As they go along, the veterans shoot the ball from the range a little bit better, the youngsters wanting to slam dunk. And now, last year's defending champion, who will be in it this year, is Tim Legler. Legler, last year, he's coming now off of a knee injury, but last year set a record in the third round competition with a 65 points, and he's back in it this year.
Only by going alone in silence can one get into the heart of the wilderness. Other travel is mere dust and hotels and baggage and chatter.
A 360 double pump tomahawk jam.
If you're into slam dunks, maybe you'd better stick to watching the Nestle Crunch Slam Dunk Contest on TNT. To catch Slam Dunk Mania, get to a store, buy Nestle candy, collect the wrappers, and get free NBA gear. The Nestle Crunch Slam Dunk Contest, February 8th on TNT. Check for the time in your area. It's crunch time, baby.
Recently, Jones Intercable and MTV co-hosted an event at Truman High School in Independence to raise the awareness among students to the dangers of mixing alcohol and driving. The students heard from a representative of the Missouri Highway Patrol, a parent who lost a daughter in an alcohol-related accident, and saw two videos which illustrated the dire consequences of driving while intoxicated.
On behalf of Missouri State Highway Patrol, I'd like to thank Jones Intercable, MTV, and all the students and teachers who have worked so hard at Truman High School to put this event together.